function that reproduces 3D audio on and off. Adjust value until the pattern is just barely visible. Wait, what? I hate it when brightness screens are like this. I guess before we get too far into the game, I just want to do a brief intro. So sorry we have to stare at this brightness option for a little longer, but I don't want to move forward and miss some kind of cinematic or something. So it's Resident Evil 2 Remake, and I've been anticipating this game a lot because I'm a huge Resident Evil fan. I'm a huge Resident Evil 2 fan, and I love the series, and I've been waiting for this game with a lot of anticipation. Now, to be fair, I haven't been a huge fan of where Resident Evil went. I never played 6, although I have it, and I'm going to play it. And I haven't played 7, and to be honest, like, I'm probably gonna end up playing it just to see what it's like, but I have never felt any huge desire to play Resident Evil 7. I played the demo for it, and just was not very impressed, and really had no desire to play through the whole game. And nothing that I've seen from the game has made me want to play it. So, frankly, when they announced this, I was a little tepid, and I was not all that hyped. And then when the trailer dropped, I was a lot more hyped for it. Not only because it looked good and it looked, like, scary and interesting, but also because I had recently finished replaying the Resident Evil 1 remake for the first time in a long time. And while I enjoyed that replay, I also... it also highlighted for me a lot of the flaws in game design in those original games. And I was kind of like, you know what? The old fixed camera, tank control Resident Evil games, they're still great. But I can see now that those games had a lot of flaws. And, I mean, obviously, like, you know, any game series needs to evolve. And I could see that even at the time. But it made me appreciate the later games a lot more because I was like, you know what? The series just had to modernize. Otherwise, it would have been a joke. And even though I think now you could probably release a fixed camera tank control game just for nostalgia's sake, and I think it would be received all right, I think it would have been just suicide for Resident Evil to try to do that. That being said, I do think that the later games, especially Resident Evil 4, I think lost a lot of the classic Resident Evil flavor, and I wish that game had stuck, like, as far as like story and presentation, just stuck a little bit closer to the original games. I think I personally would have liked a lot more. I know that I'm in the minority in that because I know the game is very well received. But yeah, that was kind of when the series started to lose me. I played through 5, and while I enjoyed it a lot more than I thought I would, I never really took that game seriously. And I did a co-op replay of Resident Evil 5 recently, and wow, that game did not hold up very well for me. So, sorry, by the way, that I'm stuffed up. It's just that time of year. What are you going to do? So yeah, basically, after all that, I was just a lot more open to anything that Resident Evil wants to throw at me. And of course, being a huge fan of the game, when they announced this and it was just coming up so soon, Because I think it got announced. I mean, we knew it was coming, but I think the trailer dropped, was it E3? This past E3? And now it's the end of January and the game's coming out. So, it's pretty quick. So yeah, I was just very open to this. And certainly you could, I mean, I guess you could say remaking Resident Evil 2 is setting yourself up for failure as much as success, but you're working from a very strong template. So yeah, let's just see what happens. Now I'm gonna be streaming probably at least the next 3 hours. It's early in the morning. I actually meant to start playing this last night, but I got engrossed in a TV show I was watching. The Ted Bundy tapes, which is, I really did not think that show was going to be that interesting, and holy smokes, I ended up watching all 4 hours back to back. But that's neither here nor there. The thing is, it's now, let's see, 9:30 a.m. So not exactly like spooky times. And I debated even doing this live stream and talking my way through the game, but I figured, because that'll probably ruin a lot of the horror aspects of the game. But I'm gonna try not to talk just for talking's sake and let the game play out, and just kind of do, I guess, a live impressions where if I see something that just that I hate, I'm gonna call it out. But it'll also allow me to comment on the successes of the game. It's a cold morning here, so hopefully the fan on my heater won't be too loud. But again, what are you gonna do? It's that time of year. All right, so I think without further ado, we can keep going here. Oh, okay. Max brightness and min brightness. Interesting. Okay. I guess that counts as barely visible. Let's do it. Adjust the value until the picture on the left disappears. Please check your max min brightness if the picture on the left won't disappear. Oh, it's a typewriter. Disappears completely. Okay, gonna make it pretty dark. Before I read this, I'm just gonna turn up my headphone volume from the controller here. Hopefully, they won't be too loud. RE:NET is a completely free service that gives you a deeper look into the Resident Evil universe. Send your play data to gain access to a variety of services. Blah, 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 blah. Sure, I think I've been asked to do this before, and oh yeah, I got two weapons for pre-ordering the game. Okay, so much like the first game, this is split into two campaigns. Let's look at our options first, though. Camera inversion. Invert Y-axis, invert Y-axis. Field of view. I'll probably end up lowering that, but let's just see what the default is. Camera speed. Let's not mess with that for now. Camera wobble. Well, I really don't like that feature in games, so I'm gonna turn it off. HDR mode off, brightness, film noise. Let's leave the filters on. Reticle settings. Okay. Do I need a reticle and a dot sight? Or all the weapons can have dot sights? And tutorials. Well, I guess since it's the first playthrough, let's just leave those on. And hopefully they won't be too disruptive. Hang on, let's go back in there. Audio. I do generally turn the background music down just a notch, not to get overwhelmed. Dynamic range, large. I'm not really a sound guy, so I'm not sure what that is. Controller, speaker. Let's turn the controller speaker off. Okay. Okay, so there's two campaigns, and I'm not sure. I've most tried to stay away from a lot of information in this game. I don't think I've looked at anything since the trailer dropped, actually, so I managed to do a pretty good job. I just didn't want to spoil anything else for myself. I figure, like, having so much knowledge of the original is going to be spoiler enough. So just for the sake of, like, giving myself an extra scare or two, maybe an extra moment of tension, hopefully not too many moments of frustration, I've stayed away from any information on this game. So this is fairly blind, so I have no idea how extensive the game is, how if it makes a difference if you play one or the other first, like you could in the first one. So I'm just going in blind. Let's see, a few days after radio silence from his post, Leon S. Kennedy drives to Raccoon City to scope things out. Unbeknownst to him, a nightmare awaits. A different nightmare awaits Claire Redfield, who is unaware of just how drastically her very ordinary life is about to change. Cool. All right, let's go. Select a game mode for players who are unfamiliar with action games. Hardcore. No autosave, stronger enemies. Huh. Huh. I don't normally play games on hard at all, and certainly not right off the bat. I've done it a couple times. The Last of Us was one example. I'm not sure what made me do it in that game, but I ended up not liking that game. Not because of the difficulty. This is tempting. Saving requires an ink ribbon. Well, that's Resident Evil. No autosave. Resident Evil. Stronger enemies. So, it looks like I would think that you have to be locked into this difficulty for the entire game. I guess this sounds interesting. I think I'm gonna do hardcore.
Man, I'm serious, okay? I saw this with my own eyes.
Oh, I believe you, buddy. I believe you. Just tell us a story. Tell us a story.
Okay, well, it was last Friday night. I was walking home from the bar, and this woman started coming towards me. She was staggering, you know, so I figured she was drunk.
Whoa. Okay, tell us, be honest now. How many drinks did you have?
No, man, I barely had a buzz on her.
Oh, come on.
Look, just listen, all right? She got closer, and I got a good look at her.
You had to see her eyes, her nose, her whole face. It looked like it was rotting.
Yeah.
She looked like a corpse. Like a walking corpse, man.
Sounds like my wife.
I've never seen anything like it. I haven't been able to sleep since that night.
All right, calm down, buddy. Calm down. Just, hey, you gotta stay strong, okay? Don't give in to fear out there, right?
Yeah, well, you got that right. If you freeze up around these things, they'll sink their teeth in them.
Just getting good. I need some sleep. Oh, shit!
Around. That's weird.
Okay, first of all, the game started phenomenally because it already had a truck driver in it. And the truck driver from Resident Evil 2 is my absolute favorite character in the entire franchise. The guy that's like, "That guy's crazy! Why you bite me?" It's like, just get back in your truck. We need you for the cutscene later. The game looks phenomenal, obviously. And I really liked that opening shot on the burger because I had no idea what that was. So, good start. Let's look around.
Hello? Anybody there? Something's not right. You all right? Don't move. I'll be back for you. Officer, you need help?
Stay back, sir. I got this.
Hey! Wait now!
Help me!
Freeze! I'll shoot! Son of a bitch.
I was already hitting every button on the controller, so I didn't see what the melee button was. I think it was R2. Okay, I think I got him. What a way to go. Oh, this is a bit like the Resident Evil 7 system, huh? Okay, interesting. Let's see if I can do this. Okay, I'm fucking dead in Resident Evil 2. Guess I'll be a little more careful.
Hello? Anybody there? Something's not right. You all right? Don't move. I'll be back for you. Officer, you need help?
Stay back, sir. I got this.
Hey! Wait now! Help me! Freeze! I'll shoot!
I guess you have to get grabbed. Oh, he didn't stay down at all. Hmm. Okay. People in the store that I didn't see before.
Don't shoot!
Get down! You alright?
Yeah, I think so. Thanks.
You can thank me later, when we're safe.
Holy shit.
Some answers at the police station.
Wait, you're a cop?
Yeah, Leon Kennedy. You are?
Claire Redfield.
Live around here?
No. I'm looking for my brother. He's a cop too.
Well, it's a good thing we found each other. I don't know what to expect anymore.
That was a pretty strong opening. Very clever in a lot of ways.
Attention all citizens. Due to the citywide outbreak, you are advised to take shelter at the Raccoon City Police Station.
Free food and medical supplies will be provided to everyone who needs.
God, this is so unreal.
The police station is not much farther. They'll know something.
Yeah, but what if we're the only ones? What if there's no survivors?
No, there's survivors. Big city. There has to be. Looks like we're walking from here.
They brought him back!
okay?
Yeah, I'm all right. How about you?
Can't stay here. It's not safe.
Go on ahead. I'll meet you at the station.
I'll be there. This is out of control.
Is that my alley? Is that my alley? Oh, I hope I made the right way.
It's everybody. They've all turned.
Is that a PT reference?
There it is. The station.
No gun shop? Okay, I'm gonna take a quick breather here because I want to, first of all, turn the sound up. The game seems a bit quiet compared to other games. I just wanted to say how impressed I am by that opening. First of all, it's short and sweet. Yeah, I don't want to get too much into, like, game design, but there's a lot of stuff jumping out at me compared to my Resident Evil 1 playthrough. Obviously, you can't really compare the games. They're going, you know, decades apart and going for something completely different. Okay, so I'm back. So I mentioned earlier how... let's pause it to quiet the zombies. I mentioned how I replayed the Resident Evil 1 remake recently. And the main thing that jumped out at me at that game is that... after so many years of playing the original, the sequels, and the remake, and now to go back... in 2018, and finished that game again and play through it, what jumped out at me most was, okay, Resident Evil is essentially an adventure game. It's a spooky adventure game with combat. And, you know, each room in the mansion, the Spencer Mansion, is essentially a puzzle room. Not only does it contain puzzles, which are separate from what I'm talking about, but what I mean is each room is a puzzle. So sometimes there's a combat puzzle in a room. Sometimes there's some kind of actual puzzle. And sometimes, you know, the puzzle's just that you have to come back with something to complete a puzzle. So I'm probably not explaining this super well, but as somebody who's been playing games for a long time and used to play the old point-and-click adventure games, that's what really jumped out at me about Resident Evil, and that's something that I hadn't really ever... I guess I'd considered that before, but it just was really highlighted by that playthrough. And the problem was that knowing all the story beats and basically just being hampered by the old gameplay, my impressions were, well, listen, I don't want another game like this, you know, where I'm just like ferrying items back and forth. So far what's really impressed me about the remake is like just the way I went and got that key, and then the door puzzle was unlocked. So it's a good sign that attention has been paid to updating not just the visuals and the cutscenes, sound, all that stuff, but also to make an effort to recall those past games, but update the gameplay. So that's very important. Now, meanwhile, I made it to the police station pretty quick. Obviously, no gunshot and shotgun. And no passageway, so let's just head in.
Hello? Is anybody here?
Freaking beautiful, man. There's the three slots. What is this? It's a spade. Ammo. I'm glad I didn't stop to shoot any zombies because I had noticed that I was out of ammo. I guess that carried over from the earlier portion. Line with a shield and a dial puzzle. Open door. Too bad you can't just examine little things like that anymore. That's okay. You know. You can just look at it now, and it's a high-res model. As opposed to back in the days when you couldn't put that kind of stuff in games, so you just had to write some text about it. Looks like I need to cut the tape. Oh, item box. Crystal. Oh, I have handguns. But they're empty. Okay.
Has to be someone here. Not good.
David, Marvin, you there? I found a way out. It's in here. Send reinforcements. East hallway.
Gotta find that guy.
Map screen is useful for more than just your current location surroundings, and can also show you any points of interest in items you have found but haven't picked up. That's cool. East hallway, watchman's room. Oh, hello. And an ink ribbon. Awesome. First aid spray. Now, I've never understood why keep out. Will do. Oh no. Well, that's no good. Fuse box, huh? It's tense.
Jesus.
Open up! Hurry! Open up! Open this goddamn door!
Hey, who? Oh, that door.
Come here, hand.
Help me!
I got you. Give me your other hand.
Goddess statue, 3 medallions, go underground and exit. Okay. So, pig, wheat, eagle. Oh, I thought that was a medallion. It's just the man. Oh, shit. Save! Shit, I forgot. I didn't save. This is bad. Oh fuck, I'm fucking completely surrounded now. Okay, some of them are faster than others. Barely. Why'd you look over there, Leon?
Kennedy. There was another officer. I couldn't.
Here. I'm sure you did what you could, Leon.
Does anyone know what started this?
Honestly, all you need to know is that this place will eat you alive if you aren't careful.
Yeah, well, I was supposed to start last week, and I got a call to stay away. I wish I'd come here sooner.
You're here now, Leon. That's all that matters.
Okay, Lieutenant. I'm ready.
Hopefully, you'll be able to find a way out of this station. That officer you met earlier, Elliot. He thought this secret passageway might do the trick.
This is good news. We can get you to a hospital.
No, I am not the priority.
Lieutenant, I'm not just gonna leave you here.
I'm giving you an order, rookie. You save yourself first. I'd come with you, but I just know you now. Now, you'll need this.
can't take...
Stop. Don't make my mistake. If you see one of those things, uniform or not, you do not hesitate. You take it out. Or you run. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So Resident Evil 5 style. I love how he's so hurt, but in the cutscene he was fine. That's pretty good. I like that. Did I see a plant? So it was a lion? Lion medallion. Why you always lying? You medallion. Man, taking damage in this game really fucks you up.
So Elliot was right.
Yeah, the passage isn't open yet.
I can't believe I forgot to do this before. Whoa. Pick it up, buddy. I just want to move it to that slot because I'm anal. Oh well. Oh shit, I'm in danger. Now I'm fine. Okay. Can I cut it with the knife? Sweet.
This is not how I imagined my first day.
progress. What the fuck? Clover. Oh, what? That's not good at all. That's not how you get ahead in life. Leaving windows open during a zombie outbreak? It's not a good strategy. Refunds around the front, ma'am. Oh, shit. Why? Get away. Oh, he still wants a snack. That's pretty scary, man.
Son of a bitch.
I agree, Leon. I agree. Oh, you don't get shit from the enemies. Okay, let's look at that map. Wait. It's a little hard to get oriented here. appears his keypad no longer stolen. He's missing a few keys. I suggest that the person fall for this mess. Fix this right now. Spare keys, huh? Steel boy. Ooh, I want that shotgun. Oh, shit! Where did you come from? Where the hell did you come from?
What the?
Wait a minute. I thought I picked that up already. Come on, game. Combat knife. What is that? Is that a grenade? And what do we got over here? 1 of 2 of 3. Oh. Gunpowder. That's what that is. So I gotta make ammo, huh? Down just me and three others. No weapons, no ammo. Too many skirmishes have drained us mentally and physically. We're not going to make it. Officer Phillips once suggested we escape through the sewers. Apparently there's a secret tunnel under this place, left over from its museum days. I'll brush your idea off before, but now it's not sounding all that bad. Yeah, there's no proof there's even a tunnel or that the sewers aren't infested with zombies, but I don't want to sit here and wait to die either. It's a long shot, but I'm going to try to find out what I can about that tunnel. Yeah, Mr. Cassidy, we're providing a very special guest for your first assignment. Desk. The key to your success is in the initials of our first names. Input the letters in order of our desks. There are two locks, one on each side of your desk. Make sure you get them both. Basically, your first task is to remember your fellow officers' names, but you figure that out that much out, right? Good luck, Leon. By the way, it might take a little work to get Scott to give you a straight answer. That a little bit later. Unless it really looks like I can solve it now. Got me.
Jesus.
Yep. Time to go. Just stop. Oh, I hate that shit, man. Endless head bobbing. No. That's a lot of progress lost. Come on, you don't have to move your head that much. Nobody moves their head that much. Only characters in video games. Thank you. Wait. Oh, we still have that? Well, I guess the question now is, do I want to go... I guess I want to grab this ammo regardless.
This but is not how I imagined my first day.
I think that door is also open. Actually, go check that door. Orphanage, huh? Okay, another herb. Take that. I'm trying to remember what is on this side of the building. I think this is where the helicopter is, right? Oh, and it's a spade key. Okay. So I can't get there anyway. So that room used to have a save, a typewriter and an item box. But if I remember, it was kind of hard to unlock or something, so they just consolidated it all into this room, which is fine. I guess I pretty much want to go this way, huh? I was so close to coming back, too. I was right there. Okay. Well, hopefully I can do a little better. Kinda got whooped. Gross. Oh my god. Ah, oh, the dead zone in these games. That's really what gets you the most, is like you're...
Shit!
Trying to fine-tune your shot. And it won't let you. Oh wait, what? Homie. Bloody couch. Oh. See, where did that... I guess before when I got attacked, it was just that other guy coming back. And I hadn't killed him. Okay. Leon, it's a zombie. You can't give him orders. It's hilarious. So, George Scott, and he won't die. Come on, dude. Are they unkillable, technically? Initials, key is to your success. Input the letters in order on our desks. Alright, so I'm dumb, but luckily I have pen and paper. There's Rita, followed by George. Preceded all by Marvin. And then there's David. Elliot. And I'm assuming Scott, since they already told me who's going to be difficult. I'm already stumped. Neil. So who the hell is Scott? Okay. 24 rounds? Holy shit. Why would you ever even want the DLC weapons? Maybe they get an extended clip, I guess. There's a safe. And there was nothing else here, right? Oh, haha, funny. Funny. See, there was another zombie there. What the fuck? Okay. Thank you. Yeah, I'd spread a note about it. Appreciate it, though. Nice. Looks dank as fuck. Looks dank as fuck. Scepter book. I like this saving system that mimics the old games because it does give the game some tension. I obviously have no idea what the checkpoint system would have been like. In the normal difficulty. Probably should have saved it for the completely open window, but I figure since this is safe, or next to a safe room. Come on, like, why would you move your head so much? I'm just watching him now. That's like the zombie playbook. Just move your head. Where'd you go? Hey, buddy. Come on.
Son of a bitch.
For me, that's for sure. Nice. Portable safe? A small portable safe. Very happy. Okay. Oh. Figured it out. Shotgun shells. Yeah, I guess I'll take them. I guess when I come back, you'll be ready for action, huh? I know what goes there. Glass, but not the boards. I am happy. I'm starting to think that unless you actually blow their heads up, the zombies are not technically dead. Which is a distressing thought, to say the least. I wonder how long those boars will last, if they're permanent or not. Kinda think they're not gonna be. So that's open, but I don't know where it leads. Actually, I may have some idea. I think that's where the STARS room is. Oh.
There you are. Come here. Take a look.
Yes. I knew she'd make it.
Oh, you know her?
Yeah. Name's Claire. I came into town with her.
You can get to that courtyard. Through the second floor. East side.
I'm on it. Thanks, Lieutenant.
Yeah, I got a little confused there because the transition was so sudden that actually what I thought happened was something that happens in Dark Souls constantly, which is the camera just moves behind some object in the foreground and blocks you, but yeah, just a little loading. I'm just kind of looking at the map right now. noticing that it's dynamic, which I really appreciate, because ever since Silent Hill, the idea that, you know, you can mark puzzles and kind of mark your progress in a game like this is really useful. That door was, to me, it appeared to not be locked so much as, like, impassable. So I guess that's what red means. I haven't played Resident Evil 2 in a long time, so I'm actually not super familiar with the layout of the police station anymore. And plus, this is all a little bit different. Not sure I needed to be in here yet. Okay, so it's this room. Oh, there's two of them. Wait. I need a crank or something here. Okay. I have a theory that they won't follow me into this room. Piece of plastic shaped like a book. And that's for that puzzle. I thought those were my footsteps for a second. Hope that guy never gets up again. Because if it's just this guy, I can deal with this guy being alive and I can just run around him. But if I forever have to worry about these guys coming back to life, that's a whole different story. Took me a second. Hey, what's up, Coffin? How you doing, man? Thanks for coming by. The game's great, so. Detonator. Oh, this is that room, right? Yeah. Thank you. Okay. So I think with all this ammo, I'm gonna go back through this hallway. I'm gonna board up that broken window. Oh, can I even go this way? I cannot go this way. I must go. You are waiting for me. Buddy's still dead. I'm happy to see. I was considering boarding up that window, but that one, oh, something big hit that. That one at least has glass, whereas this one has nothing, so I'm gonna go with this. Zombie there. So yeah, I'm just trying to figure out what the zombie rules are for this game. It's time to go back over here. Wait, can I go back over there? Oh. So I guess that's done with. Where can I now? Huh. Is that a spade key? I could discard it, but why waste a perfectly good key? I don't know why I'm doing this. Oh, man. A little bit more stuffed up than I thought. In fact, since I have some Dayquil, I'm gonna take that real quick. Be right back. Okay, I'm back. Sorry about that, but I figured if I feel like I'm getting sick, and I plan on streaming this most of the day since it's my day off, I figured I'd do what I could to keep myself healthy. This might seem really redundant, but I figure if I'm keeping myself secure at all, let's be methodical about it. So that's at least part of the house. One room, basically. Made a little bit safer. And hopefully those boards are permanent. Thank you. Fuck. Who's this?
Hey! Leon?
Claire! Hold on! I'll be right there!
Okay!
Claire! It's so nice to see you.
How you doing? Helicopter just came out of
here. Yeah. In one piece.
I'm guessing you don't have a key in one of those fancy pockets?
Unfortunately, no. But how are you doing?
Driving.
That's good. Any luck with your brother?
No, not yet.
There, don't lose hope. I'm sure we're gonna find him. Damn it. You know what that means?
Yeah. Dinner time.
Claire, I think you should go.
Don't worry about me, Leon. You take care of yourself.
Yeah, you need to go. Now.
Okay. Let's get through this. Both of us.
Good idea.
Marvin, we've got a situation here. I'm surrounded by zombies. Marvin, do you copy? Marvin! Damn it.
Come on, man. Oh no! Why did he stand all the way up? Seriously?
God damn it. What the?
Come on, dude. Like, you can't... Oh, he's back on his feet. Holy shit. Maybe they can even, like, regenerate health? Ugh! Stop moving your fucking head, please! Wow. Sure, I wanted that to happen. Okay, so now you're in there. Shit. I was not fun with those two little guys over here. That was not fun at all. I feel like that took way too many bullets. I love how that guy keeps falling on the desk. That's hilarious.
Shit.
Stand up and please stop moving your head. Yes. Oh no, you are unbelievable. What? Where are my bullets going? This light on. Wait, that's on? I thought it was a lot brighter. Okay, maybe with just this guy. Get in the room. Second floor. I think I'm doing okay. Definitely enjoying the game. I think it's, there's been a couple of frustrating things. I also don't like that they made the zombies, like, move their heads a ton. But overall, it's done a really good job of recreating the classic experience. It's actually impressively good, to be honest. Looks like zombies can come through doors. They feel like a threat. That's for sure. Oh, she's up. She's not dead, though. That's funny. Alright, and then there's gonna be the guy in here. Right? Wait. I might be a little confused now. Where's the bathroom? That's second floor, I guess. Let's see how far that zombie chased me. Sounds like she's right there. Here we go. Great sign. The Nothing Locker. That thing is huge. A lot of broken windows too. It's second floor, I guess it doesn't matter. So Okay. Sure. Got one more slot. Flash grenade. Got lots of shotgun ammo. Dongle key. I guess I didn't need to bring the cutting tool. Sent 3 number combination safe moved from Star's office to West office. Left 9, right 15, left 7. Okay, so I got a combination. Not sure what the battery is even for. Kind of feel like I need to go kill this thing if it's still up. It's gone now. Damn. For a second. You know, I don't think I gave this room a proper look, so let's look around. Yeah, it looks great. Made in heaven. Fucking weird ass shit. Not even gonna look in that direction. Linen room. And it's locked by his diamond key. Must be a very important linen room. Half a cheeseburger, scorpion, whatever that is. Map. Oh, okay. Let's go in here and unload some ammo. Oh, they're all alive.
Oh boy.
No, no, no. Fuck. Guys, back on there.
Shit.
Let's look at that. Oh shit. Damn it, they're both back up. Yeah, that is just straight up menacing. 9-volt battery, what is that for? Is that everything I left behind here? Gonna come back with my dongle. Just not even gonna look. Thank you. see, now she's up there. And you were, what, are you taking a nap? What's going on over here? How you doing, buddy?
Still alive.
Yeah, barely. Barely alive. Okay. Don't know what the battery's for. Cutting tool. I can't think of another place to use it. But might come in handy. I got stuff to make shotgun shells. Sure, there. I feel like I wasted that flashbang back there. I don't think I should save. Let's go back up through the second floor. Now that the helicopter's exploded, it should have changed something. Wait, that's a square thing. So, do I need to go back and get that? Damn it, I should have just gone.
What the?
Should have just gone. Should have just gone. Resistance. Let's just get the shotgun first and then we'll deal with that. Okay. Just gonna say. There's a safe in there, safety deposit. Maybe the crazy thought here, but thinking maybe this dumb jack doesn't work like a normal jack and instead requires a 9-volt battery. No, it's actually a pull. Okay. Oh, no, no, no. So that was pretty dumb. I think I can be somewhat forgiven for trying at least. Barely touched my coffee. Wow. I didn't blow his fucking head off. That's really disappointing.
Jesus.
Although as far as shotguns go, that's a pretty good shotgun effect. This is fucked. Left 9, right 15, left 7, left 9. cool. Awesome. I'd actually would have preferred a little bit of ammo or something. Not great, actually. Not great. Why does it tell me there's something else in here? Or is it just red because there's a zombie in here? Well, we are kind of we're coming up on 3 hours, and if I'm being honest, I am a little bit confused. I feel like the only place there's an area up here I didn't explore. Is that correct, or does this just lead back? The red book, which I'm pretty sure is for in here, but I've got to take one of these guys out. But is it though? Like, man. So, the red book seems like it's going to be for a puzzle in here, but I haven't actually located it. So, while I could waste the ammo on these guys and... try to figure it out, it could be a total waste of time. Actually, the puzzle could be up here. But otherwise, I'm kind of at an impasse here. So I'm thinking this might be a good time to take a little breather. That didn't work. I was hoping maybe there'd be something under one of these. Oh, there is. Scared because this is my last ink ribbon. But I figure I'm in a good enough place. I found one of the pouches. I have lots of ammo. So hopefully, hopefully, sorry, I'm trailing off. Yeah, I think I should be able to make something of this, so just gonna go ahead and do it. Take a little breather, get something to eat real quick, and then I'll come back a little while later and keep playing some more of this and hopefully make some progress. Really enjoying the game so far. I think they've done a great job of recreating the classic experience, but it feels modern. It feels a lot like Resident Evil 5 more than 4, really. But really, it's not like either one of those games, because it's so much more puzzle focused and more horror focused in those games. Did I not come in through the front door? I guess what's his face barricaded it after I came in. Marvin. Yeah. Really happy with it. Definitely worth my $60 so far. Anyway, I'm going to sign off from there, and I'll see you guys later.